हेलो, टुडे वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट हाइड्रोस्टेटिक ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम HTS। वेर इज द हाइड्रोस्टेटिक ट्रांसमिशन सिस्टम आर यूज, हाउ इट्स वर्क इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन टू व्हील्स एंड फोर व्हील्स इन अ कार। दैट्स ऑल आर वी हैव टू डिस्कस इन दिस लेक्चर। फर्स्ट वी हैव टू गो टू इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट। What does a hydrostatic transmission? A hydrostatic transmission exists any time a hydraulic pump is connected to a dedicated to one or more hydraulic motor. Means that there is a one hydraulic pump is there, and this hydraulic pump is driven by any external sources like as a IC engine or any electrical device for a prime mover to run the hydraulic pump. And this hydraulic pump are connected to a hydraulic motor where we have to transmit motion. Versatility is achieved by the making either or both pump and motor are variable displacement. Means here that sometimes of we have to require a variable speed, slow speed, medium speed or higher speed. So its motor and pump are made as a variable displacement, so we can achieve a number of stages speed in the hydraulic pump and hydraulic motor. This confuse result in the called as a constant output power transmission. It's give a constant output power, not given sometime like as a intermediate output. Means one time is given a drive, secondary time it can be stopped, but a hydrostatic transmission give a continuous output like as a rotational motion. What is the advantages of hydrostatic transmission system? Hydrostatic balancing for those demanding application. Like as a advantages of hydrostatic transmission include power transmission. Most of the hydrostatic transmission used for a power transmission. It's like as a force type, rotational type, as a pressure type we can use. We can also use in a remote area, infinity variable speed controls, self overloaded protection, reverse rotation capability, dynamic braking and high power to weight ratio. If you have to pull heavy weight from one place to another place, then we have to using a hydrostatic transmission system through a load and unload condition. Sometimes it's used for a dynamic braking, so it's give a smooth braking, not to prevent any type of the damages. This is the normal figure we can see as a hydrostatic transmission system. Sometime in case of a normal vehicle, rotary motion produced by an engine is transmitted to a wheel through mechanical power transmission systems consisting of belt, clutch, gearbox, axle shaft and differential. The power transmission system also performs the task of modifying the speed of the vehicle by engaging and disengaging gear at different level. The changing of gear either manually or it's automatically create a disturbance in the power transmission of vehicle. If you have to consider there is a one four-wheeler car, the gearbox transmission system is given a gear shifting 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If you have to using by mechanical power transmission system from shifting first gear to second gear, third gear up to fourth gear, it sometimes give a disturbance in a power transmission system. Not any constant power transmission we can get from the mechanical transmission system. So in place of mechanical power transmission system, we can use hydrostatic transmission system. It's give a smooth and continuous rotational to a wheel, and it is a better balancing for a four wheeler vehicles. This problem solved by the using a continuous variable transmission CVT. CVT means continuous variable transmission, also called as a gearless transmission. Hydrostatic transmission is one of the modern type of CVT system and is used in most common of modern vehicle. If you have to consider that the Activa, Honda Activa, that's all using a normal transmission system like as a CVT. This is not a hydrostatic transmission, but a continuous variable transmission system using by using of variable pulley with operate by belt. This is the drawing of four wheeler car. We have to go through a some notation. This is the normal view, and this is the first wheel drive. Here is the second wheel, third wheel, and fourth wheel. Can understand? This portion R is a front side wheel drive, and this portion R is a rear wheel drive. Top side is mentioned as a front side wheel, and bottom side is as a rear wheel drive. Here the in between the engine are mounted. This square block are a engine, and the pump is directly coupled with engine, means the primer like as a IC engine give the rotational speed to a pump. This type of the pump is a variable pump because of we have to mount this hydrostatic transmission in a vehicle. And vehicle speed are very as depend on road condition. Here we have to attach variable hydraulic pump. This black line are directly coupled with the all four wheels as a one line as a inlet for a pressurized liquid or fluid, and second line is a return fluid to a pump. That's called as a hose. The four all hoses are coupled with the four wheel drive. Here is a motor are attached to a all wheel. This all motors are a fixed speed. There is a not variable motor, so we cannot vary the speed of motor. This motor are run operated by the hydraulic pump. The hydraulic pump give a pressurized fluid and motor can run. This RPM is transferred to a wheel. For each wheel, this rotation are transferred and vehicle can pass from its one place to another place. First, we have to understand in detail the engine rotation are give to the hydraulic pump. This pump is a variable pump, so we can vary the speed as per our requirement. Then after the this variable pump give the pressurized fluid to each wheel. This each wheel is coupled with the fixed motor. Here is the attached the fixed motor. This fixed motor rotate by the force of pressurized fluid. If you have to giving a more and more pressurized fluid to a motor, the motor rotation can increase step by step as per the given the pressurized fluid from the variable pump. If we have to give lower level fluid, means we have to decreasing the flow of pressurized fluid, the motor RPM goes to a down, so the rotational of wheel is goes to a down, and step by step it decrease the speed. It has a hydraulic variable displacement pump and variable speed motor we can use also here. This is in this drawing we have to only using a fixed motor, but in place of we can also use as a variable motor. This piston pump are typically used as a axial piston pump. They are likely to sways plate axial piston pump type, so can vary the speed of engine rotation to wheel rotation. The pump shaft is connected to a engine shaft and engine drive the pump. If the pump is work on a under hydraulic pressure and this pressure given to a motor, if you have to not require any speed, the angle of sways plate is zero. Here the angle of this plate is speed of the vehicle is controlled by the changing of sways plate angle. If the vehicle is not in a use or any drive condition, the angle of sways plate we can set as a zero, and the fluid cannot flow from the pump to a hydraulic motor. This all operation and operated by the hand lever at driver cabin. When the hand lever we have to put in a natural position, the sways plate angle is right angle to cylinder axis. Means here is the consider as a one axis and a right angle to a sways plate. So that its condition there is a no fluid pass from the pump, and at this time the wheel don't rotate. In a secondary condition, if you have to drive our vehicle, when the hand lever is moved forward, the sways plate is tilt in a forward direction. You have to draw, here is the main axis of the pump and the sways plate angle we have to tilt. At this time, the forward direction maximum up to we can tilt in a 15 degree, not more than 15 degree we can move the sways plate angle. The pump oil in forward direction and the rotor and wheel are rotated in a forward direction. Discharge of pump and the speed of vehicle are proportional to a angle of sways plate. Here the generation of angle 0 degree to 15 degree. It's the directly proportional to a speed of vehicle. If we have to moving the angle 0 to 1 degree, the oil is normally passed through a motor and is give a starting speed or low speed. If you have to increasing of sways plate angle 0 to 5 degree, that is give a more RPM. If you have to change the angle from 0 to 15 degree, it's give a higher fluid flow from pump to motor and it's give a higher rotational speed boost. Because of that, the many more are fluid passing from the pump to a motor and motors give a highly rotational. If the hand lever is moved backward from its natural position, the sways plate tilt in the backward direction. If we have to change the angle from backward side, so it's give a backward rotation, means in a reverse condition. The maximum limit for a backward side is a 7 degree, not more than 7 degree we can transfer in a backward angle. So this position has delivered oil in a reverse direction. And here is motor and wheels rotate in a reverse direction. At this position, this wheel are rotated in a reverse direction. This is the hydrostatic transmission system and four wheel motor. All each wheel are connected to a motor, and this motor are connected to a variable displacement pump. This type of the pump you have to using sways plate pump. is the next drawing for a hydrostatic transmission system. Only single pump using with a two-wheel motor. We have to using a single pump. These wheels are a front wheel and this wheel are a rear wheel. You have to using only single hydraulic variable pump and only attach rear two wheel. In this drawing, the engine are rotates by the gasoline engine or any diesel engine. This rotational RPM gives to a hydraulic pump, and this pump is as a stress plate axial piston pump. This axial piston pump are rotated and give the pressurized liquid fluid to a rear wheel motor, and this rear wheel motor can transfer. Here the front wheel is free from the connection of the engine and hydrostatic transmission. Only we have to give rear wheel drive. This type of the drive, it's better for a low weight or small vehicle. Here the next is a hydrostatic transmission, one pump and two each wheel drive. Here the this portion is front wheel drive, here is a rear wheel drive, this portion is a engine, and engine rotational is given to a individual variable pump. Here using a two variable pump for each wheel with a motor to give rotational RPM to a rear wheel. This is the basic construction. This is the front side of the car, rear side of the car. One engine are mounted. This rotational RPM given to individual variable pump to each rear wheel. Here in this case, the one side inline HST and secondary inline HST. Here the, in between, one gearbox is mounted through a universal joint. Because of the this two rear wheel are not run at a continuous constant speed in a any movement of the circle or any movement of the curvature, the speed are vary from both wheel. Here this rotational RPM given to a pump first and pump second. This variable pump give the pressurized fluid to a fixed motor, and fixed motor can run, and this rotational RPM transfer to a rear side wheel. In this drawing, only one advantage is that this both wheel are independent. Here both wheel are independent, so it can run smoothly in a curvature or any turn point and easily balance the car. In the previous two figure, we have to show the hydrostatic transmission connected to a four wheel and two wheel, but there is only and only one hydraulic pump used, and the pressurized fluid can transfer the from hose line to a fixed motor. So that type of the hydrostatic transmission work only and only fixed speed to a both wheel. Here in this system, two variable pump are used for a drive to a hydrostatic transmission system. It can use for a variable speed. If you have to run this car in a turn places, any curvature places, which at this time the rear both side of the wheel are not run at a constant speed. The speed are different from all wheel. At this time, it's create a better balancing to a car, and not it goes out from this centrifugal force to a outside of the rod. HST has important advantages over the form of power transmission. In the normal cases, most of vehicle can use mechanical power transmission system. But in the latest technology and latest vehicle are used as a hydrostatic transmission system or continuous variable transmission system, CVT. The first point is transmit high power in a compact size. The size is very compact and transmit loads of power. Exhibits low inertia, there is a work in a low force area. Operate efficiency over a wide range of torque to speed ratio. The efficiency for this hydrostatic transmission is very high. In the hydraulic pump and hydraulic motor creates a heavily torque, and this torque we have to transfer in our speed ratio where we have to require from transfer one place to another place in a vehicle. Maintain a control speed even in a reverse regardless of load within a design limit. If you have to using in a mechanical power transmission system or gear transmission, belt or clutch transmission, it's not a control speed because of the transmission shifting from gear to gear, it's maybe create a disturbance in a transmission system. But in a hydrostatic transmission system, it not give any type of the disturbance. It work with a smooth speed. Even if it's also a smooth speed or control or maintain speed in a reverse position, if you have to require a run vehicle in a reverse direction, in this condition it's give a better control speed in a reverse condition. Maintain a present speed accurately against the driving or braking load. If you have to go fast with a heavily speed, it's present or accurately maintain the speed. If you have to apply the brake load on the wheel, it's time, it's also a stable and maintain a regulating of the speed. Can transmit power from a single prime mover. Here only one hydraulic pump we can use and use as a multiple location if your position and orientation of the location are changed. Only one hydraulic pump we can operate, then after the multiple location we can use the hydrostatic transmission or do work two or more than two location. Can remain stable and undamaged under the full load at low power loss. Sometimes the mechanical drive we can give the full load condition, it may be damaged due to the heavy pressurize on the tooth and PCD circle. But in a hydrostatic transmission, if you have to give the full load condition, it cannot damage under with also a low power losses. There is a no any power losses at duration of the full load condition. Doesn't creep at zero speed. It doesn't create a directly to a heavy speed to a zero speed. Provide a faster response than the mechanical. Mechanical drive can run step by step increasing speed due to the many more are friction occurs during the gear and gear ratio and engagement and lots of friction is there. But in a hydrostatic transmission, no gear, no belt or any pulley we can use it. That means there is a friction point of view we can consider, there is a low friction and it's give a faster respond. Electromechanical transmission comparable rating and that. If you have to consider is a electromechanical, it's also a faster respond. Can provide a dynamic braking. That's type of the response we can also use for as a dynamic braking to maintain a stable of the vehicle. There is some disadvantages for this, the hydrostatic transmission system. That type of the system is a more expensive than the traditional transmission system or mechanical transmission system because of the working fluid is a high viscous oil, high variable displacement pump, high variable displacement motor. That's all component work as a under a higher pressure. The cost of the these parts is very high, means that the more expensive than the traditional transmission system. And we can also use as a high viscous liquid or oil, that's also essentially costly. The efficiency of a hydrostatic transmission is slight over around to 80 to 85% compared to a mechanical transmission because of the this working of the fluid, sometimes of the sleeve, and the, some of the fluid can pass directly to a reverse line. So the efficiency of this hydrostatic transmission is 80 to 85%. The hydrostatic transmission system generate a highly torque at the starting point. Sometimes is hydraulic torque can give slip on the soft surface. Soft surface, sometime of the rainy surface or glossy surface, is that time the wheel are slip on the road due to the generated of high torque due on the hydraulic pump. It cannot be towered like a conventional vehicle, is they may damage and seal in the pump by the creating back pressure. This is because the driver motor turns with a wheels, but the pump does not. We have to discuss in the our last drawing. There is a independent hydraulic pump and hydraulic motor are used because of the sometimes one wheel can create a higher load condition. It may be damage the seal and pump due to the higher pressure of the pump. This type of the system we have to regularly maintain and check and inspect the pressure of the oil. Okay, thank you.